Thank you for watching another sermon by God's Lost Internet Ministry. We appreciate you keep returning, and those of you who are just tuning in for the first time, whatever day of the week this is or time. Today we're going to be talking about God and who He is to us. Who He should be to us anyway. Today's sermon will be taken out of Exodus chapter 20, verses 1 through 7. But before we get into service, I would like to bring everybody up to an update on Shar Morris, how she is doing in her fight against cancer. She made it through surgery. She's on the road to recovery. Let's keep her in prayer and her family. Let's keep everybody else in prayer that we've been praying for. Tanya Arnold and her family. Kevin Harris and his family. Jason Gibb and his family. Mary Pasnaw. Let's keep these people in prayer. There's so many more. We have a list on our Facebook site that you can go to get this list and pray for people, because it's a privilege that God wants us to do. Let's say a quick prayer to get into the service that it may be of God's will. Father in heaven, we thank you for this day you have given us. We thank you for the sunshine. We thank you for the rain. We ask you to watch over us as you did this last week. Keep your hand of protection on us. Help us come closer to you, God. Let us be good servants, and we thank you for all you've done for Shar Morris and her family. Now be with us in this service, Lord. Let the Holy Spirit flow through me into others so that they may become closer to you. This I ask in Christ Jesus' name, our Savior. Amen. Now, in chapter 20, verse 1, we read, God spake all these words, saying, I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Thou shalt have no other gods before me. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven images, or any likeness of any thing that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them. For I, the Lord thy God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children unto the third and fourth generation of them that hate me, and shewing mercy unto thousands of them that love me and keep my commandments. Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain. For the Lord will not hold him guiltless that taketh his name in vain. So many I hear, either at work, at stores, out walking around, that talk so much about God, but in a negative way. I don't hear much good about God when I'm out walking around or at work. It's a sad thing, really. Sometimes it really gets me down. That people are using God's name in such a fashion like that. How can they call themselves Christians? How can you call yourself a Christian if you think so less of your God? There are many gods out there. This time of year, we see grown men betting against other teams, trying to win it big off their teams, either football or baseball, golf, whatever you have it now. They make these sports people into small gods. So their love of money, their other little gods, will build up in their wallet. But I wonder, if they are honest with themselves, how much do they really win? Somebody may be chuckling and said, well, I hit the mother load. Is that really winning? What kind of God do you put ahead of yourself? What God do you associate to your life? Well, there's only one true God. One in the end of life that does the judgment. These so-called other little gods that you put your money and faith into and buy their shirts and hats, mark up your body with their little sayings. The gods that you put into banks to save up for that rainy day. Those gods aren't going to help you when you die. When you're gone from earth, those gods stay here. They fall into somebody else's pocket. Somebody else will be wearing them. Doesn't matter. You won't have it with you. You may have it in your casket because you don't want anybody else to have it. But it still stays down here on earth. Who is your God? Well, there's only one true God, the great I Am. He's a very jealous God. And many people don't take that to heart. At work, I hear people using his name in all kinds of ways except for prayers. They wonder why they have such a bad day. God tells us not to use his name in vain. But we do it anyway. When it's told us right out in the open. God tells us not to have any grave images, any likeness of anything in heaven above, beneath the earth or on the earth. Or in the waters. Huh. This is all right there in black and white. This is what God is telling us. Why are we refusing? Why don't we listen? Could it be that because God is so merciful, so loving, that he lets us choose what gods we want in our life? Could it be that God loves us so much that he lets us do what we want? There are so many of us that are spoiled, one way or another. We're all spoiled little brats, getting our way, taking advantage of other people. And then we cry when we don't get our way. If we had a God that ruled with a heavy fist, then we would say, well, that ain't right. He doesn't love us. He won't let me have anything. No, God gives us a choice to be spoiled little brats, to take advantage of other people, to worship these little gods that walk all over other people around us. Sometimes I wonder why God is so merciful to us. How he could take and love us so much for all the evil that we do, that you do and I do. How can he love us so much that he sent his son down here to die for us? And we don't even give him a second thought. Maybe we think about him on Saturday night when we promise somebody that we'd go to church with them and we really don't want to. Well, let me tell you something. God is with you 24/7. God sees everything we do, hears everything we say, knows what we think. But he still lets us have our way, makes us have choices. He never gives up on us. Well, he sent Christ to make it easy for us to follow him, to be his servant, to want that love that he promised us, to take care of us, to love us. But no, there are so many around us that I cry sometimes. I'll be standing around the time clock and hear people talk about God and Christ. But it's not in any good way. They're usually using his name in such a vain way that I just want to hold my hands up over my ear and cry out, why? They don't believe in God. They believe in their little gods. You say, how can you say that? I see them at church. I see them giving so much. They share everything. I ask you, are they really? Are they sharing everything? Or are they just in it for the show? To get something back in return. Many people are that way. They won't get anything in return. They don't want to donate money, their time, anything. God led the people out of bondage. He still sees people in bondage today. He wants to lead them out too. He sent Christ Jesus down to lead us out easily. We don't have to go marching through a desert. We won't have to follow anybody. Just Christ Jesus is there to die on that cross for us. Made it so easy, but we still make it so hard. Scared that we have to give up something that we love. Well, let me tell you something. One day soon, you'll be giving it up anyway. When you're laid down in that grave. There is no coming back. You're going to God to be judged. My question is, are your little gods going to be there to help you? No. As you look upon God, it's going to be such a bright light that darkness is going to be all around it. It's going to be noticeable. You're going to fall down on your own face without being told to. You're going to look upon that and feel the love, the warmth. And he's going to ask you questions. And one of them's going to be, why didn't you believe in me? Why did not you do my servant's work? Why didn't you care? Why didn't you just believe my son? Christ came down here to make it easy because God knew that we could never follow the laws. We are too imperfect, too selfish. We're too spoiled little brats to be able to follow rules. He had to send somebody down here to take our punishment, to take our sin. To make it easy for us to get to heaven. So easy that we think there's a trick to it. It can't be that easy. But it is. So many people use God's name and Christ's name in vain. But they don't realize it. They use it like every other word, I swear. It hurts my ears sometimes to hear people talk that way. But for me to stand up and say anything at the place of work I work at, put my time in, I would be considered wrong, doing something out of place. I could be held in contempt as a hater. But I don't care. These people violate my God. They violate your God. He is a jealous God. You think he's going to set up there forever and let things happen? No. How many of us have made pictures of God? Of Christ? How many wear special outfits suited to hold our team in honor? These little football people or baseball people or golf people or soccer or whatever sports you believe in, they wear their clothes, hoping that they will do something special for them. Is this not putting them in place of the one true God? What about these people who love to work hard for money and sock it away? Who find and work extra hard to find little ways to save a penny or two, to earn an extra dollar here or there? Are they not putting that in place of God? I ask you to look at yourself. down with the Bible. Pray with the Bible. Open up to God. Ask Him to show you where you stand in His way. Are you a good servant of God? Are you willing to do work for God? Are you willing to take time out during your day and pray for others who need God's love, healing, who are lost and need to find God? How selfish are you? God gave His only Son for us. God wants us to live outside of bondage. God wants life forever for us with Him for eternity. But no, God gave us a choice, gave us a mind to be rational, to think things out for ourselves. And what did this do? Look around. Compare what we are today to 5 years ago, 10 years ago, even 50 to 100 years ago. See how life has changed around us. For the better or for the worst. Many will say that it changed for the worst. The world has. But I feel that my life has come closer to God one day at a time. One step, one sentence, one paragraph as I read and study. I am closer to God than I ever was before. What makes me different than anybody else? Is it my faith? Is it my praying for others? Praying for myself? Praying to God? Is it my faith in God? Did God give me more than He gave you? No. Christ is inside, wanting to take over our heart. It's up to us to make that choice, to believe who God really is, the one great God, and not these little gods with a small g. Many of us will bow down, sit in our chairs, and watch TV on Sundays, betting on games all through the week. Not giving the true God His just, serving Him like we should. God loves us so much, He wants to take the burdens away from you. But first, we have to understand who God is. We have to believe that God is the one true God. That He is a jealous God. He doesn't like us when we do these other little things. He will put up with it for a while. But jealousy will come to the head. God does not like to be looked down at. He does not like His name used in ways that it should not be used. He will hold it against you. If you are that dumb that you can't think of other words to express yourself, I am sorry for you. Money, TV, movies, sports, hobbies, these are all little gods. They take us away from the one true God. And these little guys work for Satan. They may be little, but they grow and take and eat away at us. Until finally we want nothing to do with our one true God. Until it's too late, till we're laid down, buried and gone. Everything that you thought was important to you is gone. And you're standing there in front of God. Seeing that He really is real. That there is something beyond us. Is it going to be too late for you? Is Satan going to be laughing at you? Because you fell for his little sins. I ask you today, take the time, sit down, and rediscover God. Understand who God really is. Look around you. Look at everything. Put things in place. Tell God how much you really love Him. Show Him by getting down and praising Him in the right way. As we close this service today, I ask you to think about it. Think of where you are in your life with Christ. God sent Christ here die for all of our sins, to take our punishment so that we can be in heaven with Him. Don't wait till it's too late. You will never know when the day will be when we die. When we'll be face to face with God. Don't wait. Do it now. Father in heaven, we thank you for this day you've given us. We thank you for this place of worship. We thank you for this ministry that goes out online. Lord, be with all of our friends, our supporters, people who believe in you, the true Christians, Lord. Watch over them. Protect them this week, Lord. And help us, Lord, to bring others closer to you so they may find you and you save them, Christ. This we ask in Christ Jesus' name, our Savior. Amen.